Hi there, welcome back to my channel. I'm here with a short project share and then a tutorial for this cute gift set. A tote bag with some notebooks and a little wallet in there. Yeah, you could use the tote bag as a gift itself. So it's just from paper. We've made this with the Knitwit Sunflower Cottage collection. And in the collection, they have an actual image of a tote bag like this. And I tried to recreate it with paper. And I've only used 8.5 by 11 inch paper, as you can see in the tutorial. And I think it turned out pretty cute. It's nice and sturdy because of these strips here. And I've embellished it a little bit. So yeah, cute gift bag just as this. But I filled it up with some notebooks. So I've made one larger notebook and I've just did it really plain with pattern paper, a little embellishment on the inside, just a quick notebook that you can also place in your as an insert in your traveler's notebooks. And I did a smaller version of that as well. So, and what I did with this one, well, not in this one, this is just plain, but I've made one earlier and I've shared that on my social media, on Instagram and on Facebook. But I've placed some strips of pattern paper and then you could place a 3x4 photo here. So that's an idea that you could do, but you can also just use it for notes, right? It's just whatever you like. And then I've made this wallet that was like the wallet in the memory box that I've made earlier. Well, it was designed by Paul Ford, but I've created that one as well. And I've used a little Velcro dot to keep that closed. And yeah, you can put some embellishments or something that you want to keep with that in here. So I thought that was a cute set. And yeah, I shared it and people were telling me that they would love to see how I've made it. So that's what I'm going to show you right now. So let's go to the tutorial. Okay, let's start with making the actual tote bag. So I've printed a striped pattern paper. And if you're using the same collection, I rotate the stripe like 90 degrees. So my stripe is in this direction when you print it on the 8.5 by 11. And what I also did is I print on the Epson Premium presentation paper in a matte finish. So you need to print on the really white side to get the really nice print, but you can also print on the back. It's still a perfectly good print, but it's not as bright as when you print on the really white side. But I chose to print a dot print on here as well, just so the inside of the bag also looks nice. But you don't necessarily have to do that. You can also just leave it white and use some tissue paper, for example, to make that look a little bit more pretty. But from this piece we are going to make the tote bag. So I have my 11 by 8.5 size paper in my scoreboard, and I'm going to start with the 8.5 inch side on top. And you want to have the side that's going to be your outside facing you. And I'm going to score on that 8.5 inch side on top. I'm going to score at 1 inch from both sides, so that's on the 1 inch mark. And on the 7.5 inch mark. Then I'm going to turn it towards that 11 inch side on top. And I'm going to score at 3/8 of an inch. And I'm trying to hold it in place. Oh, 3/8, not 1/2. And I'm going to score at 4 3/4. 4 3/4 at 6 1/4. Yes, 6 1/4. And at 10 5/8 of an inch. So that's again 3/8 of an inch from the cut edge here. So I'm going to turn this around and I'm going to use some 1/4 inch tape. And I'm going to place that between the cut edge and the 3/8 inch score line on both sides. And I'm just going from cut edge to cut edge. And on the 3/8 inch score line, I am going to fold and burnish, but I'm not going to stick anything down. That's going to be the last thing that I do. But I do want to have that score line pre-folded there. Okay, next up, it's going to be a little bit hard to see, but I have my score lines here, the two score lines. what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my scissors and I'm going to cut on the outside of that score line. You can do that with a really slight angle towards that intersection of your score lines there. So not too much of an angle, just slightly. There. Fold this one. And now I'm going to round this off a little bit. Now I'm really terrible with doing that, but it doesn't really matter in the end. You're not really going to see it. So I'm going to fold these flaps in. I'm not burnishing this score line, but I am folding on the score line. And burnish it with my finger a little bit. And then I can have this right here. And I'm just going to try to round it a little bit. Maybe you can use a corner punch or something. But you just don't want it to be too straight. There we go. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Okay, I have my scoreboard back in. And I have these flaps here. Again, I want to have the pattern that I'm going to have on the outside facing me. I'm going to get something that I can mark on my paper with. And you don't worry about it too much. You're not really going to see it. But don't make it too big of a mark, but I'm lining up the edge of my paper here with my 6-inch mark. That's just easy for me. And from that, I'm going to mark 1/4 inch inwards on that side flap. So just a little mark there on top. It's really hard to see. And I'm going to do the same thing here. Well, I can do that from that 6-inch mark. So now I'm doing that at 6 1/4. I'm going to do the same thing on the bottom in a second, but I'm just going to show you what we are going to do. I'm going to fold this part in here. You can this one you can also fold in if that's easier for you. And now I have that black line here on my scoreboard. So I'm going to line up the mark here with that 6-inch score line. And then I want to have my intersection of my score lines also lined up with that same score mark. So that's where the black is helping me. So I'm lining that up, making sure I really secure that in place. And I'm going to score. So I'm going to score a little bit diagonal right now. So make sure that you can hold it in place. And this is not really working for me when I'm doing this sort of stuff. So let's get this one. Give yourself a start if you need to, just like I'm doing. Just make sure that you're in that score line. And make that diagonal score mark. Right there. And I'm doing the same thing here. So again, I'm folding this in so I can see that little intersection or the point where I need to go to. I'm lining that up and I'm lining it up there. Holding it in place. It can be a little bit more tricky on this side. For me at least. And again, I'm making that score line. And because the tape is already on there, it's a little bit harder to get that score line made there. And now I'm going to do the same thing on this side of the piece. So I'm just going to repeat my steps. Okay, yeah. So again, I'm going to get my 1/4 inch tape. And now on one side, I'm going to apply tape along the cut edge. So I'm going to do it on this side of the paper on both sides. I hope that makes sense. Give that a burnish so I know that I can remove that easily. And now I'm also going to fold on the score lines here. We haven't done that yet, but I'm just folding it and not placing too much pressure. I don't need a really sharp fold there, but just it helps if it's pre-folded. Okay, what are we going to do? I'm going to fold this inwards and I'm going to bring these two flaps together. And I'm going to, here my tape is on this side, so that's the one that's going on the outside. I'm going to line up the edge of my paper here with my 1/4 inch mark there. And that's how I'm going to stick this together. So I remove that tape backing, and here you need to remove it also just a little bit. You can combine it with wet glue if that feels more comfortable for you, but I'm trying as carefully as I can to get that lined up without sticking before I want it. That's one. And I'm going to do the same thing on this other side. And I just place my hand on the inside to give some pressure on the bag to burnish it on top of each other a little bit. And now what I also like to do is I'm going in here, fold this down, put a little bit of wet glue here, and then I can glue that down there as well. Just roughly, but you want it to stay in place. At least I want it to stay in place. Okay, so now all we need to do is fold over the 3-inch flap for a little bit more finished look on the top. And it also makes it a little bit more sturdy there. There we go. Okay, so the tape backing is removed and I'm just starting in the middle of one of the longer sides. I felt that was the easiest way because your short side is going to be a little bit more tricky. But just carefully work your way around. We already pre-folded that score line, so that should cooperate with you. And then I am going to burnish that so it has a nice good stick. Okay, so that is done. And now we want to have this to come out a little bit, right? So we didn't make that score line for nothing. We are going to pinch on that score line a little bit. The diagonal score line that we've made. Just like that. And I'm going to do the same thing here. And if you want to, you can also do this before you assemble it to fold on those score lines, of course. But I felt with folding over my 3/8-inch flap that it was a little bit easier to do it afterwards. And then the base of the tote bag is done. You see how that shape just formed itself with folding on those score lines? So now I'm going to make the handles. Again, I did that with pattern paper and I totally love how the inside with the polka dot is looking here. So much better than the blank inside. But again, you don't need to do that, of course. So for the handles, you're going to cut 4 strips of paper, 11 inches by 1.5 inches. And we are going to make these more sturdy strips with that paper. So I chose the white paper from the solids from the collection, but you see there is a little bit of print in there. It's really hard to catch on camera. But yeah, you can use whatever you like, of course. So I'm going to put this in my scoreboard with the 1.5-inch mark on top. And I'm going to score at 3/8 of an inch. And at 1 1/8 of an inch. And again, that's also 3/8 of an inch from the other cut edge. So you can also do 3/8 of an inch from both sides. So again, I've scored on the side with the print and I'm going to turn it over to the bumpy side and I'm going to place again some 1/4-inch tape between the cut edge and that score line. And then I'm going to fold and burnish the score lines, but I like to do one at a time because it's so small. The other side, if I want to fold this one down now, this is going to get in my side. So I'm just removing my tape backing and sticking that down. And I'm start in the middle and work my way out. And then I'm going to do the other one. There we go. So you want to have 4 of those. And what am I going to do? I can use this. You want to have something that is a little bit rounded off. So I can use my score. How do you call that? Not, you know what I mean, what I'm using for scoring. But just something with a rounded edge. And I'm just going to pre-curl 2 of those strips. And the other ones I'm just putting to the side for now. So I'm going to determine how I want to place these strips. And I'm going to do I'm just using my lines. That's the nice thing of the stripe paper. I can just determine like, oh, I want to have it on that line or on that line, and just have that lined up. So I think I'm going for the top of the line here, and I'm gonna go about 7/8 of an inch in from the score lines that I have here, the straight score line. So I'm just going to roughly mark it. Well, roughly, I try to be precise, but it can be a little bit tricky. So just a small pencil mark. Just make sure that I'm on the same stripe. Because I want to get it somewhat straight on there, so I can align it on the other side later on. So I'm going to hold this one in place where I want it, and I'm going to mark until where that is going, so I know how high I can put my tape or glue, whatever it is that you're using. And I'm doing the same thing on this side. And I'm just going to use 1/4 inch tape again. So I'm going to where I can see the fold, that's going to be my inside, right? The nice side will be on the outside. So I'm going to stay roughly under that pencil mark, but just so you have an idea. So I'm also, for myself, just quickly measuring how far is this handle going in. And that's about 1 5/8 of an inch. So you want to keep the same measurement on the other side later on. So just remember that, write it down, whatever you need to do. So your handles are going to be the same length, right? So just remove my tape backing. I can combine with some wet glue for some wiggle time if I want to. And obviously I want to, as you can see. So, and I'm just using my pencil line here and the line on my pattern paper, because that's easy to get it on here straight. And give that some time to dry. Burnish it a little bit. And then I'm going to bring it to the other side and again align that with that small pencil mark and the line. And this side is a little bit harder because you're... So this side can be a little bit more tricky because this strip is pulling on itself a little bit. So you want to really hold it in place, but that's the first handle down. So I'm going to do the same thing here using the same measurement. So 1 5/8 inch down, 7/8 inch in. So those two handles are on there, and now what I did with the other bag, and I like it, you can leave it like this if you want to, but I am going to connect the handles with the two other strips all the way along the bottom towards the other side, and it also makes this part a little bit more sturdy, and it stands up a little bit better. But it's a little bit tricky, but if you just take your time, I think you'll be just fine. So I am going to bump one strip up against the handle here. And let's do that on the other side, because this is going to be the front of my book, because here my line, connecting line, will be on top of a line. It doesn't really matter, because I'm going to decorate it and hide those little connection points anyway, but still, I'm just going to make this the front of the back. So I'm just pushing that up against each other, and I am going to mark where I need to fold this strip. Just a light pencil mark. I'm doing that on the outside of the strip, that's going to be seen later on. And again, I just like to use my 6-inch mark for this. I'm going to make a score line as best as I can. It can be a bit tricky. So now I have that line, and I know that this bottom part is 1.5 inches. So that would mean that at the 7.5 inch mark, I would need to score again. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my score line in between. This is a little bit tricky, but in between that 5 7/8 score line and the 6-inch score line. And now I'm going to score the 7.5 inch mark. So I make that space a little bit larger than 1.5 inches. There we go. I'm turning it over to this inside where the paper comes together. And I'm going to place some double-sided tape. And I'm going here, roughly. You don't have to go all the way to the end because you don't need to complete 11 inches there. So I just, guess how far I need to go. Give that a little bit of a burnish. And I'm going to fold on that first score mark that I've made. And on the second one. Okay, so I folded on those two score lines. I'm going to give it a dry fit if I'm happy with how this goes. And I like this. So I'm going to remove the tape backings. If it wants to cooperate with me. Just to that first fold that we've made. There we go. And then again, I'd like to combine it with a little bit of wet glue. And that's just for the wiggle time. That I can really place it where I want it. So getting that strip in. And align it as best as I can, right? Try to really bump it up against the handle. Hold that in place. And I like to burnish on the inside of the bag because then I can give the best pressure. And now what I'm going to do is, my tape backing is still on there, so I'm going to fold the whole strip over, place it on top of the handle here on the back side, and then I'm going to mark to where the strip needs to go. And again, you're gonna do this as best as you can. And if you are feeling comfortable in placing it in your paper trimmer, you can. But I think I'm just going to do it with my scissors. There we go. And now I'm going to remove the rest of the tape backing. Add some wet glue and hope for the best. Could have even cut down a little bit more. Maybe I will. A small hair more. Like I said, I'm going to hide it with my embellishments anyway. So I think I'd rather have a small gap than that I will have some overlapping. So now I'm going to try to get in the bag, burnish it a little bit from the inside. There we go. And now we have that continuous. And like I said, this is my worst part. I know that because that's where you're going to come together. So that's why I determine what's going to be the backside of my bag in the first place. And here we have, we see that little edge, but it nicely lined up. So I will repeat this process with this strip again. Okay, so the handles are on there, and now you can decorate this like you want to. So I have cut out these flowers that I'm going to put on there, and what I'm trying to do with my embellishment is try to cover up the where the strips come together a little bit. So I'm going to put this on there, and I also have a butterfly, and I'm going to give that a little bit of dimension. So I will place that on there. So yeah, let's just do that, right? So I'm just going to put some glue on here. So I'm just trying to put my hand in there so I can give a little bit of pressure from the back. Oh, so sticky. Okay, and I just think I'm going to do something like this. And then I have some buttons. They are in the collection as well. And I've sized them down to about 3/4 of an inch. And then I've used my dies to cut it out. And I've also cut out a back piece with white cardstock, because my circle die cut out the white edge from the actual button. And then I'm going to place the first one on my overlapping. So then I have that covered. Because I believe in the actual design that is in the paper collection, they are both a little bit closer together towards the bottom, but I really want to hide this here. And then I'm going to place one somewhere there. And I'm going to do that on the back as well, just to make it complete. So I'm just eyeballing it a little bit, but somewhere there. Okay, and with that, I have finished this bag. Of course, you can decorate it however you want. You could always make an eyelet somewhere and have something dangling on it. That's also cute. And this, as a standalone piece, you can use as a gift bag or, you know, something. But I've made some notebooks really quick and easy to go in here. So I'm going to show you how I've made those as well. So I'm going to put this to the side for a minute. In the collection, I found these designs. You also have a green one, I believe. So this is actually a 12x12 paper, but I've sized it down to 8.5x8.5, and then I can print it on an 8.5x11 sheet. You have some white on the top or bottom, and you can use that to print some embellishments, for example. So from this one, I'm going to make the large one, and from this one, I'm going to make a smaller booklet. So this one, I'm going to cut down to 7 inches in height. So I've cut this one down to 7 inches in height because I felt that was better balanced with the tote bag. You can keep it to the total length of 8.5 if you want, but I felt this was a little bit more balanced. And then I've cut the green gingham or plaid, I'm not sure, I believe it's called a check pattern in the collection, to 8 3/8, so like 1/8 of an inch smaller than this paper, 8 3/8 by 6 7/8. And I'm going to fold both of these on the longer side in half. And you can score if you want to, but I'm just going to align it here and then carefully burnish that fold. And actually, I want to fold this towards the other side. I need to do it like this. So, there we go. And this one, you do want to have the print on the outside. And if you want to, you can use a corner rounder. And I think I'm going to do that. So I'm just going to round off these corners here. And I will do the same thing here. So this piece I am going to glue on the inside of this piece. And you have a little bit of a border showing around. And I don't mind. It's just a small border, and that's fine with me. You can always ink edges or yeah, whatever it is that you want to do with that. But I just found that this is perfect. So I really want to have those folds together, make sure that my border is the same. And I'm just going to put wet glue on this inside here. Roughly try to get my edges nicely glued down. And then do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so this one is prepared. Now I'm going to do the same thing with this one, but only on different sizes. And I'm going to align it with the dark check, the gray check. So for this one, I want to cut it to 4.5, but I'm going to cut it just above the leaf here so I can keep the whole image intact and then cut something off of the bottom. So 4.5 by 8.5, 4 3/8 by 8 3/8. And I'm going to do the exact same thing here. So those are ready. Now I have some printer paper. This is just what I used because I wanted to make notebooks, but you can add all kinds of different things in your notebooks, right? You can also use vellum or yeah, just something that you like. And I think I have about eight or nine sheets or something, but yeah, you can do, I wouldn't go way over 9. I think that's a little bit your maximum, but yeah, you can also do a little less. So I'm going to cut on the 11 inch side at 6 3/4. At 6 3/4. And then this should be 4 1/4. So that I can use in the small booklet. This is for the large booklet. And this one I'm going to cut down to 8 inches. You can also cut it to 8 first. It would save you some time probably. So this is for the small booklet. And then this one also cut down to 8. There we go. So I'm going to do that for all my sheets. Okay, then you are going to fold these pieces on the 8-inch side in half. And I always like to do it in steps, but you can also do them all at once if you feel comfortable. But I don't, so I just do it like 3 at a time or something. So, and then I'm going to put them all together. Okay, so I'm going to start with the large template. What I did is I have a piece of cardstock or paper that I've cut down to 6 3/4 in height, 1 inch, scored it down the middle. I'm going to make a little template. So this is the same height as my insert, the printer paper actually. And I'm going to fold this in half and again in half. And in that way, it's an easy way to space out the holes that I'm going to punch. So I'm just folded in half, folded in half again. And then I get 3 intersections of score lines. And I'm going to get something to punch. But I'm going to also use a book. So here I'm just going to punch those intersections. And then I have a nice guideline. Especially if you make more of these, it's really handy and you can just save that. So what I am going to use is a large old book that I have. And I'm just going to open it somewhere in the middle. So I'm going to punch my holes in here. And I'm going to use, yeah, these have a name, but I'm not sure. So that one we will do later. I'm going to make sure that this is all really nicely in the fold. And really nice and tight in the fold here. And I think I have you have a small border on top and bottom. And then I'm going to use this to hold that in place. And put that in the book. Fold the template also in half. That's kind of handy because you want to put that in the center there. So align that on top and bottom with your printer paper or whatever it is that you are going to put in here. And then you can punch your holes. There we go. And I will do the same thing with my small booklet. But first I'm going to sew this all together so it's done. And then you know what to do with the other one. Okay, I just use some crochet thread here. And if you have seen me do this on my albums, it's actually the same thing. From the inside, I go through the middle hole. Make sure you don't pull it all the way through, you have some space there. Go back through the top. And having this there just helps you, it's all staying in place. And then go all the way to the bottom. And now this end is on that side of the thread, so I want to have my other end on the other side of the thread. So again, I'm going back in through the middle hole and make sure that my needle is on the other side. And now we are going to make it tight. So cut it off, and I can use this on my other booklet. Maybe it's enough. And tie a double knot, that's all. And then your notebook is done. Cut off the ends a little bit more. There we go, we can put that in the tote bag if you want to. You can also make that standalone piece, right? Okay, so for the small one, you would do exactly the same thing. My template for the small one is 4 1/4. And I did the same thing, so it's the same height as the printer paper. So I will do that later. So then I've made that wallet that I've was inspired by the memory box that I've made that was created by Paul Four. So here I'm going to do it with patterned paper, and my paper is directional. So you want to keep in mind how you score it. So what am I going to do is I am going to put it, let me see that I'm saying this right. I want to have it like this. So when your design is like this, turn it counterclockwise and put it in your scoreboard with 10.5 inches on top. So it's 10.5 by 7.5. And then you will score at 1.5 inches. At 4.5 inches and at 9 inches. Then you turn it towards the 7.5 inch side and you're going to score 1/2 inch and 7 inch, or 1/2 inch from both sides. So this part here where you have to like the smaller middle part, that's going to be your front. That is going to be your front. So we are going to cut away the 1/2 inches. Let me see. Here along the 1.5 and along the larger part. That's what you're going to cut away. This is what you want to keep, this part. So I'm, just so that I don't make a mistake anymore, I cut with a small angle towards the intersection on a part that I want to keep. And then you can cut this out, you can do that with your knife, with your scissors, whatever you prefer. So because this is a longer piece, I like to do that with my knife. So there we go. Now what you also want to do is this 1/2 inch flap here that you are going to fold back to reach into the pocket, but you want this to fold over nicely and it's a little bit too long for that. So I'm going to cut off a slight hair on that part of the wallet. So on the front side. So you want to make sure that you do that straight. And what you want to do is you want to see, once you've cut, you want to be able to see your score line. And I can see it, but I think I want to have just a little hair more. You want it to be able to fold over freely. And if you want to, again, you can round the corners. Let's see if I can. first fold those flaps in. And now I can round the corners. And I'm also going to do that on the other 1.5 inch part. That's going to be your closing flap. So I'm going to fold on that score line as well. And now we can glue on these flaps. We can glue this shut here. So yeah, I'm going to do it with wet glue for now. You can also do it with tape. That's what I normally do. But okay, and I'm just going to fold it in. So on my previous one that I shared on my social media, I used a little Velcro dot to keep it closed, but you can use several different closures for this. So now when you fold this flap over, this is again in the right direction, so that's nice. And you can make this a little stronger and a little prettier by, I'm calling that aligning it with a different pattern paper. So you have your scrap pieces that we used for making all these pieces. So I think this check will look nice with it on the inside. So you're just going to cut that a little bit smaller than the actual piece. So I'm going to cut it to, I think a little under 6 3/8 in my case, because you cut away the score line there. And the first piece is 1.5, so I'm going to cut it to 1 3/8. Okay, so I've cut that to size, and then we can glue that down. And if you want to, you could glue it all the way to the bottom, this piece, to make it stronger. But that does create some bulk in the pocket, and you will have less room for stuff to put in there, just so keep that in mind. So there we go. And that wallet is also done. Yeah, I need to do a closure, of course, but I will I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with that yet. So this is it. I'm going to do this small booklet off camera, but this is how you construct all the pieces and you create a nice gift set for somebody. I was thanking myself also for making nice teacher gifts this year. So I hope this gives you some idea and you could see how easy it was to create this. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye bye.